Do animals have emotions? Any child that has spent an hour with a dog will tell you that they do. But as we grow up, this certainty is pushed aside. And after all, in a world that routinely uses and abuses animals for food, clothing, and entertainment, ignoring or minimizing the emotional life of animals is rather convenient. There is quite a bit of evidence and literature on the subject of animal emotion. But for today, I want to exclusively focus on the work of neuroscientist Jack Panksepp. During his research on affective neuroscience, Panksepp found 7 emotional systems within the mammalian brain. These basic emotions do not come from the cerebral cortex, which is associated with complex human thinking, but instead from ancient brain structures that have similar functions across all mammalian species. These 7 emotional systems include seeking, fear, rage, play, care, panic, grief, and lust. The first 3 are basic emotional and motivational processes, while the last 4 are what Panksepp describes as social emotion. You may also have noticed that these 7 systems are spelled in capital to better differentiate them from the regular use of the words that may not refer to emotional systems that are traceable within the brain. Seeking is a built-in system that is essential to survival. It causes the animal to go out and look for resources such as food, water, companionship, and to explore its environment to try solving problems. If the seeking system becomes underactive, then the animal may become depressed. Therefore, it is essential to stimulate the seeking system of your domestic animal on a daily basis. This can be done through the use of environmental and sensory enrichment, such as taking the animal for a walk, food enrichment such as food puzzle, and cognitive enrichment such as clicker training session. The fear system protects the animal from danger and ensures the survival of the species. When fear is activated, either through external threat or conscious or unconscious fear memories, there are a number of internal physiological effects. The arousal of the sympathetic nervous system and associated hormones released by the endocrine system produce an increase in heart rate and blood pressure, the airway dilates, the inflammatory response increases, and the immune system is suppressed. These are all automatic responses over which the affected animal has no control over, that prepare him to escape, or if escape is prevented, to defend himself. It is common practice in the horse world to correct and punish behaviors that are product of fear. If they are lucky, the trainer may reduce the unwanted behavior by these methods, but won't achieve full resolution of the problem, as this does not take into account what is happening inside the animal mind, nor change how the animal feels about what triggers the fear. Oxytocin, the hormone associated with the care system, is however useful in reducing fear. This is why you will often notice horses engaging in mutual grooming following a stressful event. Similarly, owner may find stroking to be successful in soothing a worried horse. The rage system is linked to the fight part of the flight and fight response and is most often activated by physiological states of social isolation and anger. This explains why horses that are socially isolated and fed inappropriately are so prone to aggression and that a change of management is recommended as treatment. Hormones such as oxytocin, endorphin, progesterone, and estrogen function as antidote to rage. Mares that refuse to feed their foal and show rage towards them are most often victims of chronic stress. Chronic stress is known to disturb the normal process of pregnenolone, a building block to many hormones, including progesterone, which is a precursor to estrogen, which is essential for the hormone oxytocin to work. Rage can also be seen in animals that are unsuccessful and therefore frustrated in obtaining expected reinforcement, either positive or negative reinforcement. This can be seen when they are putting in more effort in an attempt to escape an aversive stimulus or situation, as well as when they are trying to obtain expected positive reinforcers. The panic grief system may sound similar to the fear system. However, it is a social emotion which circuits are linked to separation anxiety. Panic grief is what a young fool experiences when forcefully taken away from his mother, and later on in life when forcefully separated from a herd companion. Hormones such as oxytocin and social stimuli such as touch can act as antidote to panic. Lust is essential to the survival of the species because it ensures that animals come together and mate. It is strong in both males and females, so strong in fact that we routinely castrate male horses to reduce testosterone because it is so difficult to compete with this emotional system when it comes to handling and training horses. When horse riders label mares as moody and difficult, they often overlook the fact that mares, unlike gelding, still have an intact lust system and may be living permanently sexually frustrated lives. The care system is essential to the social life of animals. It promotes appropriate parent-child relationship, social cohesion within a herd, and as we have seen before, act as an antidote to fear, rage, and panic grief. Relationship based on care can be formed with other species, such as a human caregiver, if horse and human engage in affiliative behavior, such as stroking, grooming, and laughing together. The play system is crucial to the healthy development of young animals and strengthens social attachment by the release of endorphins. Social isolation, fear, and separation distress act as inhibitors of play. This is why we often see suppression of normal play behavior in abruptly weaned horses. To put this emotional system into an animal training context, conventional animal training that primarily involves the use of negative reinforcement and positive punishment rely on the activation of the fear and rage system, while human science-based animal training, which primarily involves positive reinforcement, rely on the activation of the seeking system and can also lead to the play and care system being activated. If you enjoyed this video, check out the other episode available in our animated series. Do not forget to like and share this video and to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more. I would like to say a special thank you to Max Easy from Horsesharming for helping with the making of the script, and of course thank you to all our supporters on Patreon. You made this video possible. If you would like to join them in supporting our free educational resources, check out the Patreon link in the description below this video. Have a beautiful day, and I see you in the next video.